Are you familiar with some of the gene polymorphisms, the SNPs in, there's one gene that I think it's NPAS2?
Yes.
That is involved in circadian rhythm, but also their susceptibility to bipolar disorder, mm-hmm. like when it's dysregulated. Mm-hmm. So again, sort of this.
Yes. Well, especially bipolar disorder, you know, if regular depression is sort of an evolved human response to the adversity of relationship, bipolar disorder is a response to the adversity of time.
Because what do you mean by that?
Well, what you see with bipolar disorder is that folks with bipolar disorder are also, they can be set off into either manias or depressions by stress, uh-huh. right? But they're also exquisitely sensitive to fluctuations in circadian patterns, right? So the great way to induce a manic episode is to just keep people awake. So there's wonderful data from the 1980s from the National Institute of Mental Health where they'd keep really very ill bipolar patients in psychiatric wards for years and study every episode. And always depressive, but especially manic episodes would be triggered by a night of sleep deprivation, right? Mm. And you see this clinically, right? So time is an adversity because it's constantly threatening homeostasis, right? So, you know, the things we're talking about, the sun comes up, the sun goes down, this happens, that happens, this happens, and your body's going up and down. Anytime things move, there's always a risk of things coming off the rails and breaking, right? And so bipolar folks are so profoundly vulnerable to disruptions in their circadian sleep-wake cycles, in their activity cycles. Ellen Frank was one of the originators of this, called Chronotherapy, came out of the University of Pittsburgh, where they actually, you know, as a therapeutic thing for bipolar disorder, part of it was education about you always go to sleep at the same time, you get up at the same time, you know, you be careful about air travel, right? There's a beautiful study from Heathrow showing that, you know, that there's a hugely increased risk of people showing up at Heathrow with a psychotic mania if they come from America to Heathrow than if they come from Asia to Heathrow, and the reason is because it's a sleep deprivation thing. If you're coming from here, that's why you're always exhausted. When you land in Europe, you've missed a night of sleep. Mm-hmm. Oh, so many manic patients I saw in my years running the emergency psychiatry at UCLA. Many of them were activated by getting on a plane.
Wow.
I was normal until I got on a plane. I got off the plane, and the world looked different, and then they're off and gone, right?
So that's what patients would say?
Oh, yeah. And first episodes were often induced. I mean, people really develop these lifelong psychotic disorders in response.
Do you think those people that are having that are a little more sensitive to the, like their circadian, they maybe have some SNP and...
This is probably why the NPAS, one of the great kind of drivers or regulators of the circadian things is a predictor of bipolar disorders because, you know, it's a condition where time, the changes of time, the recurrent changes of time mm-hmm. are just a big stressor for that mm-hmm. disorder.
Yeah, and probably lots of genes are not being regulated properly, right?
That's right.
It's like a transcription factor regulating a whole host of genes.
Right.
And so their response to things are very different because they're not activating all those pathways that you're supposed to activate,
yeah.
you know?
Yeah. Yeah. Whereas, you know, what's interesting is if you don't have that bipolar risk, most of us do not end up in the psych hospital because we missed a night of sleep.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
We end up in the psych hospital because the person we cared about dumped us or somebody died or we lost or we were shamed or you know, it's just the things, when something tees it off, it's a different register of things that tee it off, which is so interesting. It's one of the main differences between.
When I miss a night of sleep, like if I'm traveling abroad, I certainly feel strange when I land in Heathrow or any other airport in Europe or even Asia. But I certainly don't feel...
Yeah, you're not.
Yeah, I'm just kind of like, it feels kind of weird.
Right.
You know,
you're not psychotic.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
I don't actually have that SNP, so...